you have somebody to talk to?
Tell me, what do they see when they look at me? Do they see my many personalities? Oh, no.
Can you help me? Does anybody hear me? Can they even see me? This is my reality.
Can it be my turn now? Is it my turn, Pink?
Said I say it again.
Working on the affidavit and support for me to take this case back and see about getting a voided judgment and what in the hell Stephen Weintraub, Donna Fury, HRA, APS, and NYCHA did to me with the Bloomberg administration. I may seem obsessed. My friend think I'm obsessed. Oh, don't talk that stuff. Don't scare me. Blah, blah, blah. But this is about my money. That's what this is all about at the end of the day. A minimum of $2.3 million payout. Minimum. That's what this is about. I was tortured for a decade in this country. And it's the kind of institution that's been doing that to poor and lesser educated minority people. Okay? I'm fighting it. But right now, just about taking a break. Let's go hang out. My golf clubs are ready. In the midst of thinking about golfing and vacationing, well, you know, when you have money, it's not that hard to get a pretty wife, even if you're an old man. And my goal, my future, is about getting the voided judgment we just talked about, and for the $2.3 million claim in New York State Supreme Court on appeal for $6.9 million. The salutation and introduction. Then I destroy each one of these lawyers first. Of the four lawyers that's going to be there representing the 29 defendants. Then I bring about the two matters that's before the Honorable Court. Queens D.A. and NYPD trying to eliminate me for two black elected officials. Then the housing discrimination, and my job in that is to stop the civil court from selling NYCHA holdover proceeding index numbers without proof that in fact the person that they plan on putting out has had an administrative process that would last anywhere from 6 months to a year. And that means I'll be able to prove that NYCHA was conducting a form of redlining that was ushered in by the Bloomberg administration, misusing affirmative action by using a minority to go out and railroad his own colored can. That's what that's about. And then that's where it's like as important as Brown versus Board of Education, because it has national implications, because it's the July 11, 2003 remaining family member policy that started this in New York, and Obama's HUD secretary took it and seeded it all over the nation in changing those policies in order to keep public housing with a revolving door. Or else Mayor Bloomberg would have never gotten a third term, because it would have been a big scandal, and Obama would have been a one-term president without the federalization of the 21 New York City, New York State developments and bringing Long Island developments inside. Now we get to the elimination conspiracy timeline. It's about either I'm crazy or that I'm a threat to position anyone who comes in contact with me to dismiss me or eliminate me for fear of being labeled irresponsible by their superiors. Labeled me. Then we get to the housing discrimination timeline from 2004. I should have never tried to help that old lady, advocating for her. Her problems are not my problems. Okay? My mother dies, they come after me. I helped save the life. I should have never did that. She should have died, because her life isn't worth more than mine, my happiness, my everything. It's not my business. It's not my business. An American killing another American is not what do I have to do with that? It's not my business. I'm not here to save the world. I want a blank slate to start all over with my money.
Let's go hang out.
A blank slate for me to start all over. In a reasonable place, living reasonably, meet somebody, and probably see if I might start a little family. I need a blank, clean slate with my money. Love, I really don't believe in that much. Without my money, ain't no pretty woman gonna like me. Welcome to the party. Guess what I'm doing? Yeah, I got to get some darts, some new ones, and guess where I'm at? Take a look. How you doing? It's the 10th of April. By the 15th of May, I will have planted, depending on the weather. These will be headed outside by June. I'm recovering from having been a little sick and under the weather. But as you can see, I'm back on track. I got a good attitude. To help me get good results and taking my bitterness and my pain and stuffing it, because I can't blame anybody. I should have ran like a coward. But I'm not a coward. So I turned my pain, my anger, and all that stuff into a business of bringing elected officials and government employees to accountability, like this former Democrat, because I used to mess with the Democrats. This is the comeback of a semblance of Ralph Nader. That would fight for social causes, and I was severely betrayed by the Democrats, the black Democrats, the Democrats in general. The governor of New York, Andrew Cuomo, is going to try to become the first ever Catholic president this century. Kennedy was the first and the only one in the history of the United States. Y'all shouldn't vote for that guy, man. He ain't no real Negro lover. He's a professional politician. He's got a mask for you. He's got a mask for everything else. He probably has no freaking idea who in the hell he is. As far as I'm concerned, he's a freaking embarrassment to his father. Just like George W. Bush is an embarrassment to his Bush father. I will not be an embarrassment to my grandfather or my father. That's why I fought, and I fought for the people. And hopefully one day, at least Miss Sandra Jones said to me, Trice, one day New York City is going to thank you for that. And since it's nationwide, I hope this country does. By then, I'll probably be in Quebec with a nice French girl. And I won't face the kind of prejudice that I do with American women. I love American women. They just don't like me. So what am I going to do? Go someplace where I'm liked. What a life. God is a big joker, man. It's a big joker. He'll throw stuff at you and see if you can handle it. I made you strong enough. All right. I got that. Thank God. I believe by this time next year, I will know my fate. Because I plan on going to Korea. Go check out a friend. Visit the places where I used to be at, because my friend went back and he told me Itaewon, Korea is not the same. That's within Seoul, Yongsan area. Wow. I might even just go around the world, man, and travel, that I expect to get paid. Maybe I'll come back to the United States of America. Maybe. I'm owed my Social Security. Wherever I'm at in the world, just mail it to me. Well, direct deposit. That's about it. That's where we at today. Have a great weekend. This is Friday, April 10th, 2015. Personal Log.